The film you are about to see is an experimental film which utilizes techniques adopted from the advertising world. Throughout the film, subliminal cuts or edits have been added at key points to enhance the emotional quality of the narrative. A subliminal cut or edit is a single frame of film that is spliced into the middle of another scene. This single frame is on the screen for only 1/48th of a second, and hence it is unable to be seen and understood by the audience consciously. But it does make a distinct impression upon the audience's subconscious, and thus affects them without their knowing it. The filmmakers wish to apologize for any adverse effects this may have on the viewing audience.
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah, that sounds good to me too, Jim. Okay, well, then I'll just see you in about 20 minutes. I'll just take the train and get off at the second stop, right? Okay.
Well, I'll see you then. Alrighty. Okay. Okay, bye.
Hey, Ed. Ed, you all right? You all right, Ed?
Yeah.
Hey, you mind if I sit on, Ed?
No, go right ahead if you want to. I don't think I know you. How do you know my name?
You used to know me, Ed. But lately, you've gone astray.
Huh?
Ed, I'm not just anyone. Not just a typical human being. Ed, look in my eyes, Ed. What do you see?
I don't know. Are you a musician or an actor or something?
No, Ed. I'm not a musician. I'm God, Ed.
Well, I've got to go now.
Hey, so. Ed, look. Look, I can tell you don't believe me, Ed. All right? Okay. What is it? Is it proof you want, Ed? Is it proof you want? Do you want proof, Ed? Okay. You got proof, Ed. You ready,
okay.
Ed? Proof! How was that?
That was amazing.
Yeah, no.
You really are God. It must be wonderful being God.
Nah.
Loving everyone and having created all of the world and the planets.
Nah, it's really a bunch of shit, Ed. You know, people always want me to relate to them and stuff, you know? And how the hell can I relate to people? I'm God, remember?
Yeah. Must be
They're
tough.
They're always crying to me. They want me to forgive them. They want me to punish them. They want me to reward them. I don't know what the hell's going on, Ed. I start doing shit. I start fucking it up, right? Got people starving in India. There's not enough food. I figure I have a plague, you know? So I send this great plague to India, wipe out a lot of people, bring the population down to a manageable level. What happens? People start crying and gnashing their teeth and pulling their hair. And the Americans, what do? They send food and medicine over there. Pretty soon the plague's gone and there's more people in India and they're all starving again. I don't know, Ed. It's a never-ending battle, you know?
Gosh, it must be tough.
Yeah, Ed, and that's not the half of it.
No one's believing in me anymore, Ed. I mean, how do you think that makes me feel? You know, in a century or two, no one's gonna believe in me. And where does that leave me? I'll cease to exist, Ed.
I believe in you.
You'll always exist in my heart.
Thanks, Ed. But times are tough. It's getting hard for a deity to survive these days.
Yeah.
Hey, could
you loan me a buck for a burger?
Well, I don't have a dollar. All I have is a $20 bill.
Yeah?
Hey, thanks, Ed. I'll give you back the change, okay?
Oh, okay, God. Hey! I hope you remember me Judgment Day!
About it, do you? I know. You should. It would be the total destruction of everything. You should. Do you know? Are you aware of the prophecies in the Bible? Do you know that right now the state of the Antichrist is coming together with the 10 nations of the common market and the Trilateral Commission and all these people? And do you realize that in 1982 the planets are going to line up and we're going to get shit all knows what kind of radiation on this planet? You realize? What are you gonna do about it? You're gonna sit here around all fucking day and eat Twinkies? No! What you gotta do is you gotta go out and you gotta make yourself strong. You gotta get food and you have to get shelter and you have to be ready. And you have to make sure that that makes us intelligent and just separated not from any rocks or apes stays preserved for our future generations. What we call culture. What we call the products of science. And that's why I want to gather around so that our children can have it, in case there should ever be such a disaster, copies of the Reader's Digest magazine. Because it represents a cross-section of everything that we've seen. Do you have any?
Well, no, I'm sorry, I...
You don't? Well, what are these? What are these? You can be involved.
Sure, you can have them. I didn't know they were here.
Future generations will thank you.
Somebody must have...
They really will.
If you want them.
No, really. Thanks.
I mean, you're quite welcome. I don't know how they got here. I just don't know.
She'll see you now, Mr. Ditmars.
Oh, come in, Mr. Ditmars. Please sit down. Well, Ed, tell me, what seems to be your problem?
Well, for one thing, I don't even know why I'm here.
That's an easy enough question to answer. The reason you're here, Ed, is because I believe you wanted to talk to me. I'm God.
That's impossible.
What do you mean?
Well, you can't be God. I just saw God a short while ago, and he doesn't look at all like you.
Do you have to believe the first hoodoo voodoo you come in contact with, Ed? And of course, God has to be a man. What kind of mumbo-jumbo did he tell you, anyway? Ed, when are you going to realize that God is a woman? And it's that lack of spirituality in your world that's forcing male aesthetics down your throat. Star Wars this, shoot 'em up that, James Bond this, jerk off that. What'd this guy do, show you some cheap illusion and you fell for it? Listen, baby, I am the real God, and I've got something right here that can prove it to you. So hold on to your karma, because here we go. Yeah, I know. Amazing.
It must be wonderful being God, creating everything and all?
Ed, all I hope is that you gain further understanding and believe in yourself. So shoot, what's troubling you?
Well, it's not just one thing, it's many things. Like, sometimes I feel I'm on the right track and everything has a purpose and a meaning. But other times I feel like I've gotten off at the wrong station and, I don't know, it just seems like one interminably long scene after another, tagged incongruously on for no discernible reason I can see. I don't know, I just wonder if life has any meaning at all.
If that's all that's troubling you, Ed, I have something right here that will cure your human affliction.
Really?
Nothing could be simpler, Ed.
Really? Oh, great.
Okay, now, do you have $20?
Well, let's see, I got $8, I
think. Okay, that's good enough.
Well, yeah.
All right, now, are you ready, Ed?
Yeah.
Okay, are you really ready?
I think so.
All right, hold on to your hats, Ed, because here we go.
That's it. All of everything is God. Life is God. I'm God. You're God. The little birds in the trees, the butterflies on the flowers are God. All the pain.
Ed, that's absolutely the most insane thing I've ever heard you say. And I've ridden this train with you for over 25 years. Ed, listen to me. God is a constant. Reality is a constant. We're all constants. Rectangular bricks within a rectangular wall. Small cogs within the big wheel. We must all follow life's rules and axioms in order to function within its variable equation. We must listen only to the important information. We shouldn't listen to anything frivolous. Ed, follow my example. Go to college. Get a good job. Fit into the society that has molded you. Get rid of these questions, these doubts. Stop burning yourself up.
Nobody listens to you.
No one here but you and me, Ed.
Oh, how do you know my name? I don't think I know you, do I? You're not God, are you?
No, Ed. I'm Death. Take it easy.
You're Death, huh?
Yeah.
Well, are you coming to take me away or something?
I don't really know. I'm not exactly sure how it all works. People usually just come to me. I'm sitting around, I find myself in these really strange places, and next thing you know, someone comes in, and off we go to the great beyond. And that's it.
Oh, really?
Well, now you're here.
Well, yeah, I mean, you don't want to go right away, do you? I mean, how you want a drink or something first, or?
I have a drink.
Oh, yeah. You don't mind if I have a sip, do you? Thanks.
Go ahead.
Hey, how about a game of chess or something?
No, I don't play chess.
What do you mean you don't play chess? I saw you in this movie. You love playing
you
chess.
You idiot! When are you going to stop believing everything that you see in the movies? Do you believe television anchormen? What? I mean, I don't play chess.
I'm sorry. I guess I just believe any media, you know, it all... You know, that's...
I mean, who else is there? You don't usually see me every day. I mean, but...
Come on, it's time to go.
I don't want to go. Just let me finish this beer. You don't mind, Drew.
It's time to go, Isaac.
Please let me finish. Oh, come on. You. Please.
Look, what do you want to live in this world for anyway? There's death, pollution, disease. What is there to live for?
Well, what's wrong with death? You're death.
I know I'm death. It's time to go, Ed.
But, no. I really...
Come on, Ed. Hey.
No, go on.
Neglecting to eat and sleep goes hard to find. Pain on my eyes like I'm hypnotized as love burns through my mind. I'm on fire. Pull down the blind and make it like it's nice and quiet. Love's on my mind, I've got a hand that's having fire.
Done my time.